Oh my God, do you believe it? I just made a video, probably talked for half an hour, and it did not record. I can't even believe it, because it doesn't have a thing on the screen. I'm going to have to put my mouse so I can see that it's recording. I can't even believe that. Anyway, hi everybody. I am back from my trip. We got back on May 27th, I believe, and we're leaving again next Tuesday. April 27th, we got back, and we're leaving again May, 2 days after Mother's Day, whenever that is, the 12th, May 12th. And we'll be gone till almost the end of July. So I'm never home, it seems. I'm never home, and I hate that. But I like not having to cook all the time. And I like not having a, you know, bunch of stuff to do. Although, we're going every day. Every day we get up and going somewhere, seeing something, doing something. And it's hectic, but it's a lot of walking. It's a lot of exercise. So even with all the eating out, it does keep my weight in check, which is good, because when I'm home, it just starts going up and up. Age does that to you, you know? I used to always be skinny and petite, and now I'm just getting petite and fluffy, for a better word. Anyway, this video is mainly going to be showing you all my knitting and projects that I've been working on, because, you know, all the people that I'm subscribed to on YouTube, vloggers, I guess you call it, vloggers, nobody's really making videos anymore, and when they do, they're so far and few between, and so I had to find other things to watch, and I love to knit, and I love to crochet, so I have been finding a lot of knitting podcasts, as they call them. And I love it. And they show all their works in progress, the new yarns that they've bought, their finished objects. They talk about books they're reading and the coffee or tea that they're drinking. And it's great. I love it. Most of them can be pretty long, anywhere from 30 to 60 minutes, sometimes longer than that. There's one, I think they're called the Bakery Bears. They had one that was 2.5 hours. So I put that one on fast speed, 2x the speed or something, and watched it. You can still understand what they talk about and everything. It just goes by faster. So I shouldn't say that, but I did. But anyway, I love to watch them. I get ideas. I see beautiful yarns. I meet interesting, fun people. A lot of them don't comment back on their YouTube video, but they all have a Ravelry group that everybody comments in there, and I haven't really done that yet. I'm so old school, you know. I comment on the video itself, and but anyway, so that's what I've been doing. And so I decided, since nobody's making vlogs anymore much anyway, I'm gonna just do knitting ones, mostly. I will talk about other things, but mostly I'm gonna do knitting ones. So you may want to unsubscribe from me if you're not interested in that kind of stuff, but that, I think, is what I'm gonna do. And to start off, I got my splint off. my arm still hurts. It still aches. It's still swollen a little bit. My thumb is numb. I have no strength in my hand, and but the doctor wanted, he said the x-rays looked good, the bone is healed, but where the break is, which is right here at the edge of my wrist, there are tendons and a nerve that run right up the thumb, and my thumb is numb, and they apparently were traumatized, and with the splint, where it isolated my thumb, and the cast also apparently put pressure on that, which is why my thumb is numb. And it's going to take time for that to heal. And so he didn't want me to have anything on it to put any pressure on it. But, you know, it hurts. It's achy. And sometimes I get a shooting pain. Depends on what I'm doing. I try to be careful, though. But I can knit. And I have exercises I'm supposed to do. I'm supposed to touch my thumb to my baby finger, to the tip, and then to halfway down, and then to the base. And I can't actually get to the base yet. That's supposed to stretch my tendons. But these are exercises I'm supposed to do with each of my fingers. I find that knitting or crocheting loosens up my hand a little bit, and I'm able to reach that lower section of my baby finger a little easier after I've been knitting for a while. So it's a good thing. Anyway, the first thing I started as soon as I got home that next day from the doctor was the baby blanket. So I'm working on it. I've gotten this far already. She may have her baby. She's going to have her baby by this weekend. If she don't go in Friday on her own, they're going to put her in and do a C-section. So this is her blanket so far. It's coming along great. It's very easy. I don't need the pattern. It's easy to remember. And it's going along great. It's going to have a gray border on it. As I told you before, it's going to have the Tampa Bay Bucks colors. This is a bag that I had ordered from, this is from Fondant Fiber from Debbie. And I ordered two bags from her. I think she's in the UK. If not, somewhere over in Europe. I'm not sure where. But anyway, I saw her mentioned on another podcast that I watched. They had some bags by her, and they were so cute. So I went on her website, and I ordered some. And this is a big one. It's going to be big enough to hold two, maybe three skeins of the yarn plus the blanket as I'm working on it. And I love that. Another bag that I had gotten is this one. And I also ordered this. Isn't it cute? This is for wet knots, you know, like your tape measure and your stitch counter and stitch holders and a pencil and maybe anything else you might want to put in it. And then this is the bag, and it's a really big size. And this is from Kiki Boo, and she has an Etsy shop. And she also has a podcast. I think it's The Knitting Den, and her name is Denise Schultz. And she's great, and she's from England, I believe. But you know what? She has a Scottish accent. Not Scottish, Irish. She sounds like has an Irish accent to me. But she lives here in Colorado now. And anyway, she makes these bags, and they're great. And she knits a lot, too. And another bag that I got is this one, and this one came from Bead Sisters, B-E-D-E, and she has an Etsy shop. Let's see if you can see on the card. This is a two-at-a-time sock yarn bag, and I love the color. And it has a little zippered pouch in the middle that's attached that you can put, same thing, stitch counter, whatever you want in there. And it separates your two balls of yarn for your two socks at a time. Plus, you have a little snap here and a little snap there, which is you put your yarn coming up from your ball through there to the outside, and it keeps it separate and untangled from the other one. And it's just so great. I should have put my two-at-a-time socks in here. But this is that bag. I love that. The other thing is I went to my yarn store and I got some yarn. I'm doing this one faster because the other one I think I talked way too long. So I'm trying to speed it up. This is some opal yarn that I picked up at my local yarn shop. Isn't it beautiful colors? It's going to knit up like that striping. Not this one, but this one I'm going to do. I love that. And then they had a cowl, a long cowl, like an infinity cowl almost. And it was just so nice, and it was squishy, and it had little rolled edges on it, and I love it, which made it look like cording on the edges. And I just loved it. And it's just a garter stitch cowl. So easy. It was a free pattern. You can get it on Ravelry. I don't know the name of it right now. If you really want to know, ask me in comments. And I will let you know then what the pattern is. But this is the yarn I got for it. It's a rust color. It's Madeline Tosh. And let's see what color it is. If it has a color, you know, these days they don't have colors. Ginger. It's called Ginger. Anyway, I loved it. So that's that. And I got two skeins because you can make it either a long or a short one. And if you do the short one, you only need one. If you do the long one, you need two. And I haven't decided. I might make the long one. So I've got two. And then I had to get this sock yarn that I saw. Isn't it beautiful? Such spring colors. Looks like little spring flowers in bloom. I loved it. And this is Love to Die, and it's called Texas Wildflowers. And I love it. And I bought another one because I couldn't resist. And these are the purples and the orange, and this is like almost blue bonnet colors. And it's Love to Die. Live to Die. Live to Die. And this is Fuchsia. And I love it. Isn't it great? Love it. And another ball of sock yarn. This is green. It's not blue. It's green. But it's showing up blue on there. And this is Night Owl Fibers Luck of the Irish. So cool. I loved it. Loved it, loved it, loved it. And I got these little stitch holders. These are for DPNs, and when you're knitting socks on double points, and you know you have to put them down, you just unsnap this. I have no strength in my left hand, so it really hurts when I have to pull something. Anyway, you put your needles in there, and your sock hangs down, or your knitting hangs down this end, and then you just snap it. It keeps your needles in, needles in here, and doesn't poke through your bag or anywhere else where you might put them. This is like double or triple lined. I don't know. It's got a lining in there. But I bought these and I got them home. I bought two of them from my yarn shop. And they're too small. It only fits my, I only have one pair of needles that are 6 inch. And all my double points are 7 inch. So I have to go back and see if they have any that are longer. So otherwise I can't use them. Except for that one pair of needles that I double points that I have. And so that's that. The other thing, here's another bag that I had gotten. And this is from Bird Leg Bags. It's one of my favorites. Bird Leg Bags. And it's from Simply Socks. Is it Simply Socks or, yeah, Simply Socks Yarn Company. They are on Facebook. And every once in a while they put a kit together. And they have yarn in one of these, not one of these bags, but they have a bag because I have gotten other bags from them also. And I love their bags because I've had this one bent over now, so now it doesn't want to sit up. But I love their bags. Anyway, in this kit, it came with yarn, and it came with a stitch holder, and it came with little scissors, I think. And I forget what else. Anyway, here's the yarn. It is 6 mini skeins of yarn, all graduated colors that go together, and it's to make a shawl with. Isn't it beautiful? Like it can go for actually you could do the hitchhiker with this, or you could use it for any number of different shawls. I got a rainbow shawl pattern that I think would look really nice with this, or I don't know. There's just all different things you can make with it. So there's that. I am working on my two at a time socks still. You remember these? The rusty colored ones that I was working on. There's them. I'm still working on them. Have a ways to go. I thought I was at the heel. I picked these up yesterday to work on them because I thought it was at the heel. And I thought, let me just do them and just get these done. And I still have just a little bit more to do before I start to heel. I'm going to do that fish lips kiss heel. And because I made another pair of socks with that, and it is the best. It really is the best. And in here, in this bag, I love this bag. Bird leg bags again. I love it. This is my Charlie sock, which I have not worked on. So I haven't picked this one back up yet. But I need to work on it. So anyway, there's that. There's some of my projects that I'm working on. The other one is this one. What is this? Oh, my hitchhiker. I'm working on it too. As you can see, one of the other colors finally started to come in. I don't know if you can see it in this light, but it's a little bit lighter blue. And so it's getting there. I think I have like 22 points or something, so I'm about halfway done. And I'm hoping to get to some of the other colors, but as you can see, there's still more blue in there, and then it comes with purple. So anyway, so I'm working on that too. This is, I have all these projects, and I bought all this new yarn to make more projects, and you know what? I need to hire somebody just to knit all the stuff I want to make with all the yarn that I got. It's so beautiful, and I can't wait to use it. And there just isn't enough hours in the day. Here's a couple of books that I picked up. Knits for Boys. Because, you know, I have all grandsons. Has all kinds of sweaters and hats and gloves and stuff in here for boys, all different sizes, since I have them from 1 to 7 now. And then here's another one, Boys Knits. And it has a bunch of patterns, the same again, you know, sweaters and all kinds of stuff in there. I love them. And then I have a friend of mine got me this for my birthday. It's a sock art. Beautiful patterns in here for different socks. And be very challenging, but you know, I think it's going to be fun to try. Great, there's some great ones in there. The only other thing I wanted to show you is something my son gave me. I didn't tell you about my trip. Oh my God, when we got back, we went to Florida. Went to Naples, we went to Tampa, St. Pete first, saw my sister and all my nephews and nieces, all my nieces and nephew, and all the kids and everything, and then we went on to Naples, which I loved. It's so beautiful there. Then we went on to Miami and Key West, which was okay, you know, it was all right. It had a lot of nice shops and stuff. Nothing compared to Naples, though. Naples was just beautiful. And then we went to Titusville, where we went to this Kennedy Space Center, which was, you know, it was actually nice seeing all that. And then we went to South Carolina to see my son and grandsons and, of course, our daughter-in-law. And Brighton turned 5 years old. Oh, my God. Can you believe he's 5 years old already? And Ephraim is 1. He just turned 1. He's not quite walking yet, but he's pulling up and walking along furniture, and he's going to be walking any day. I can just tell. And Bright is such a good big brother, and Ephraim just looks up to him so much. He watches him all the time, and he's always laughing at him and stuff and trying to do what he does, and it's just really cute to watch two little brothers. Anyway, my son had my birthday present that he wanted to give me when we got there. So anyway, here it is. It's a book of remembrance. And it's of the animals that I have lost over the years. And it is so great. I cried looking at it. You know, it is just so nice. It's just pictures of all my animals. And, you know, my dogs. And, not supposed to look at my husband there. Scooter when he had his leg surgery, and there's Max and Charlie and Boo Boo. Boo Boo. I love that picture of her. And, of course, Casey and Scooter. Scooter's not dead, but all the rest are. And it's just really great, you know, just all through the years as they were puppies. And there's a little section dedicated to each one. And I just loved it. Loved it, loved it. It's just so nice. I will treasure this always. He's so good. He made this with, what's the name? It doesn't even say it on here. Mixbooks, I think. Mixbooks. Well, you would think it would be on this book, wouldn't you? Yeah, Mixbook. There it is. Anyway, he's used them a few times now, and this is my Scooty. Where are you, Scoot? They did great work. I gave Scooter a bath today. Oh, my God. He was so horrible. I hadn't been able to do him when we left on vacation because of my hand. And so since getting the splint off, I was able to do him today. I had to have my husband help him to hold him up to do his stomach and stuff, but I managed. My wrist is hurting. You know, it's aching, but it's okay. It's manageable. But he looks so much better. And so, you know, because we're leaving again on Tuesday to go on our next trip. We're going up the Midwest. We'll be gone till almost the end of July. And I told my husband, that's it. I don't want to go on any more trips. I'm getting to that age where I just want to sit home and knit. You know, I just want to stay home more. And but he wants to travel. So, you know, what do? We travel. And well, anyway, I'm gonna go because it's getting to the point where I don't know if I've already said this or not because I went out of order when I restarted. And did you see my? Did I show you this mug? I know I did in the first one. It's no one like Nana, not even close. I got this from my grandson Cole for Mother's Day, and he got me a card. And he wrote my name on it and everything, and it's just so cute. It's my first Mother's Day gift this year so far. And I have tea in there. I've started drinking tea. I probably already said this in this video. I don't know. Isn't it awful when you've done a video and it didn't work and you have to start over? You don't know what you said and what you didn't say and what you repeated or not. So anyway, so that's it, everybody. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.